How the heck can someone like me reinvent a salad? If I say it out loud enough times, it can happen. Chicken Caesar salad wrap, wrapped in cheese. Let's get on with the recipe.
First off, before I do anything, I'm gonna make some croutons. Now, the best way to make croutons is using day-old bread or, you know, stale bread. But if you lack patience, like I've explained I do, you can lightly bake some bread and achieve basically the same crunchiness that you would of old bread. Now, in this case, I'm using a French baguette. It's cut in half, then cut into smaller cubes. This is where you can make the cubes as big or as small as you want. They're tossed in some olive oil, hit with some salt, pepper, and garlic powder, and then thrown on a baking tray to be put in the oven. Now, for the Caesar dressing, this is not going to look anything traditional, and that's by design. If I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. My cooking style is path of least resistance cooking. We got some QP Japanese mayo, a little bit of grated garlic, some Dijon mustard, Worcestershire sauce, anchovy paste, the juice of half a lemon, and of course, some Parmesan cheese. When all that mixes up together, hit it with some salt and pepper to taste, and it's ready to go. Rule of thumb here, when making any dressing or sauce, always make extra. You know, throw it in a squeeze bottle. And to go along with this wrapped up sandwich wrap situation, I wanted to add some smokiness. And I'll save you time and the trouble of commenting below on how Caesar salads don't actually have bacon. Keep it. This is my creation, and I'll make it as delicious as I want by adding some garlic powder infused bacon bits. It's kind of made the exact same way that I would make candy bacon, minus the sugar. Add the garlic powder. As I said, this is a chicken Caesar wrap, and for the chicken part, I'm using some chicken tenders. I find that for salads, breasts and tenders are the best, and they include a nice protein punch. So with that said, I'm hitting this with some salt and pepper, some more of that parsley infused garlic powder, and pan frying them for roughly 6 minutes each side. To dress the salad before adding it to the wrap, I got some chopped up romaine lettuce in a large bowl. Then I'm gonna add some croutons and crush them up before to give it a more of like a stretch to get some of that crouton goodness all throughout the salad. Then add some dressing and some more Parmesan cheese. Give it a toss until it's all coated. And now we're gonna make the Parmesan cheese crusted part. And for that, I got a fresh block of Parmesan, and I'm using the larger part of the box grater. As I wash this back, it's the medium grate of the box grater. But obviously, before we crust up the wrap, we need to put the salad inside and wrap it all up. So I got a flour tortilla here. You gotta use the largest one you can in order to get a decent size wrap here. Now, if you're recreating this, which personally I think you could do any order you want, but this one works. A heated tortilla gets laid down. On top of that, some of the salad. On top of that, some of the chopped up chicken. And before the bacon, add some more dressing, then place the garlic bacon on top. I rarely used to heat my tortilla before making a burrito or a wrap, and then I realized that is stupid. This thing is less malleable if you don't heat it up, so don't be like me and heat your tortillas. Now, once these are rolled, there's really only one more thing to do, and that's completely cover this thing in some melted Parmesan cheese. You can use a frying pan for this, but a skillet is a lot easier. Lay down some cheese the same width as the wrap and wait for it to bubble, then place the wrap seam side down at the top of the melted cheese and proceed to roll it up. You end up getting this crunchy deliciousness that surrounds the entire wrap.
Whoa, the Parmesan cheese is so crispy to the point where, like, if I touch it just a little bit, it falls right off, which is not a big deal when you're eating it because then it'll just fall off in your mouth. Let's wrap this up, literally, in Parmesan cheese. But I was thinking before, maybe mozzarella cheese, and then I was thinking mozzarella cheese is way too greasy, even for some of you people out there, all you grease balls. This is amazing. Grilled chicken Caesar, not a new thing. Stuffing it in a flour tortilla and wrapping the entire thing in a cheese blanket, definitely a new thing. A new thing that you guys should try out. I'll leave some denominations in the description, but while you're there, why don't you leave a comment down below letting me know what else you wanna see me cook on future videos. And if you're not already subbed, hit the sub button, silly. And if you are already subbed, then turn on notifications, or else you're never gonna see another cheese blanket from me again. See you guys on the next one. Bye.